okay. How many more days can I wait? Make plans with you. And I won't let them fall through. You like.
care about the tablet. Yeah, no, no, camera is just.
Who's gonna score? Who's
gonna score? It's not me. I got fired. Okay. For real, I got fired.
Who fired you, George? Or Pedro? I mean,
no, yeah, George. Because it was one day, like, I was with a camera, and I picked up the phone, and the other day, he, like, oh, stay here in the tablet. I was like, okay.
Actually, it's kind of like
the college is going on. The
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome. We are in Montgomery College in Rockville, Maryland for tonight's Maryland Junior College matchup between the Montgomery College Raptors as they take on the College of Southern Maryland Hawks. We are just about to be underway here in Rockville, Maryland. Caleb Scarborough here on the call with you this evening. And we are off, and the Hawks quickly put the ball in the back of the net. That's something we're going to see a lot from this team, a team that averages 87 points a game. Shoot the ball really well. They have the leading scorer in the conference on their team, number five, Rasheed Cooley, averaging a cool 22 points a game. As Chachua goes up, he's going to be fouled. He'll go to the line for two shots. Foul's going to be on number 21, Magic Hewlett, his first foul, team's first. That'll send Chachua to the line. Chachua, the leading scorer for the Raptors team at 13 points a game. Raptors only shoot 67% from the free throw line as a team. And he makes the first. Raptors 10-7 overall, 5-4 in conference. They're sitting in seventh place right now in conference play, right in the middle of our season. And then on the flip side, College of Southern Maryland, they are 10-6 overall, 4-4 in conference. They are currently in ninth. So both teams right in the middle of the pack as we are halfway through this junior college basketball season. Here's Davis with it. He kicks it down. What a pass from Davis. Davis to Wills for an easy 2 points. And it looks like we have a delay of game warning on Black there. Keep an eye on that. But as I mentioned before, the Hawks, a team that has averaged 87 points a game. The Raptors are going to have to be stout on defense tonight to keep this Hawk team cool. Hewlett with it now, back it down. He spins, dishes it down, poked away from Chachua. He's looking to push. Got Trent to his left. Here's the three. Short. Not able to get to that one. That's going to go off of a Raptor, they say. That definitely looked like a Hawk touched it from up here. But Hawks will take it underneath their own goal as we are early on in this one. Raptors trailing 2-4. Chachua, the second leading rebounder in conference, pulls down almost 10 rebounds per game. Mid-range shot there looked real good from Magic Hewlett. He gets himself on the board. Hawks with some early full court pressure here, looking to get that trap. Could have been a walk call there, not called. Here's Rowe for three. Money! Big shot from Jaden Rowe. First three of our evening here at Montgomery College. Raptors, a team that shoots 31% from deep, only make 5 threes per game. Washington drives, kicks it out. Ball poked away. Here's Rowe with it now. He's got Trent to his right. Trent has it, dribbles in, takes a big step. Chichua gets the rebound, not able to get it. Ball bouncing around. Bucket there. Terrence Williams fighting for that one. He's going to lay that one in for your Raptors. Chichua and Williams both played together in high school, both at Northwest High School, now playing together here at Montgomery College. Big drive from Washington. He takes a lot of contact, no foul. Martin looks to push, has Rowe to his right, flips it up. Behind Chichua there. Chichua had the step. Martin went for the alley-oop and threw that one behind him. Raptors dropped their last contest. That matchup was on Wednesday. Lost to Cecil College 93-64. A team that has been hot, cold this season. As that one miss goes off a Hawk, that'll be Raptor ball. As I said, the Raptors have been a hot, cold team. A team that started off on fire, winning 5 in a row. Then, month of December hit, they lost 5 in a row. Won a game, then they went on to win 4 in a row. Lost 2 in a row. So a team that's been back and forth for Coach Wise, trying to figure out a way for some more consistency, to be able to continue those winning streaks, but also when a loss piles up, how do you get back in the win column? And that's the big thing for this Raptors team. Trying to figure that out 17 games into the season here. Davis drives, takes a lot of contact, could have been a carry, no call. Here's a three from Washington. Bucket on that one. Hawks look like they got lucky there, didn't get a carrying call. Nevertheless, 9-7, Raptors trailing, 16 to go. As Cooley steals it, he lays it up, and there's an easy two for Rasheed Cooley. Cooley, the sophomore out of Lackey High School, averages almost 22 points a contest, is leading the Maryland Junior College Conference in scoring. Nobody else in the 20 range like he is. He has been absolutely fantastic. That one's way off. Williams able to snatch it. He will be fouled for 2 shots. That foul will be on number 3, Reggie Washington. That'll be his first foul. Team second. Send Williams to the line here for 2 shots. Williams averages almost 9 points a game. He's shooting 69% from the free throw line. Looked good there on the first one. Williams has only seen action in 7 games this season. Has contributed mighty well for Coach Wise's club. Misses the second. Rowe gets a hand on it, bounces it back to Williams. He has it. Has Trent cutting, not able to feed him. Here's Chichua, fadeaway, ball bounces around. Nice bounce there from Chichua to put that one in. Hard take there, that one too strong. Chichua grabs another board. Rowe looking to push, Cooley on him. Rowe drives by, goes up, too strong on the layup. Here's a three from Davis, way off. Williams rebounds it. Hawks only shoot 29% from deep. They only make about 5 threes per game. Here's Davis with it. Excuse me, Martin. Martin kicks it to Williams at mid-range, too strong. Chichua tries to get it, not able to do so. Big rebound there from Wills. We've seen a couple rebounds from him here early on. Hewlett setting it up. He tosses it over to Washington. Here's Cooley. We know he'll shoot. He's off on that one. Cooley scores almost a fourth. You heard that right. A fourth of his team's points per game. A guy the Raptors are going to have to try, the big word there is try, to keep him in check tonight. Chichua rebounds that one over the top. He's going to be called, though, for an over-the-back. So foul on Chichua, his first foul, team's first. That's going to bring in number one, Marcus Rogers, for the Raptors. Also entering for the Hawks, number four, Darius Fletcher. Illegal screen there. That's going to be on number four. Darius Fletcher just entered the game and quicked up a quick foul there. Here's Rogers with it. Chichua trying to get position down low. Sets the screen. Tough screen. Rowe pulls up from the mid-range. Not able to get it. Guess who has it? Chichua. Chichua is the tallest guy out there, but uses his size in such a tremendous way. He's very agile, able to get around defenders in a way that, you know, he's listed as 6'7", but plays just with so much energy, getting around those box outs, jumping up, at least getting a hand on it, trying to keep the ball alive. And that's the reason he has the second most rebounds in conference at almost 10 rebounds per game. Almost averaging a double-double this season for Coach Wise's team. Big take from Washington. He had a hand all over him. No call there. Big rebound from Martin. He will be fouled. That foul's going to be on number 35. Justin Miner, his first foul, team's fourth. Big rebound there from Martin. Couple of tough no calls that we've seen in this game both ways. Chichua with a bump. Not able to finish that. Nice take there from Chichua. He'll go to the line. Foul is on number four, Darius Fletcher. Fletcher's been in the game for 2 minutes, has picked up two fouls. Chichua, like I said, averaging almost a double-double this season, averaging 13 points per game. Only shoots 62% from the free throw line, but shooting an incredible 59% from the field. So hasn't shot the ball well from three land or the free throw stripe, but able to take such high-quality two-point shots that it's allowed him to almost be at double-double status. Here's Davis, kicks it back out. Here's Washington with it. Cooley looking to find it. Washington drives, goes up, blocked. What a play by Rowe. Martin looks to push, he goes up. Hand all over him, can hear the smack from up here. No call, Chichua's bump, loses it. And that one goes out of play, Hawks ball. Frenetic pace here at Montgomery College. It's gonna bring in a couple substitutions, one for the Hawks, number zero, Chris Cooley, and for the Raptors, number three, Marcus Trentwinner. This College of Southern Maryland Hawks team is no stranger to playing on the road. Their gym is in the process of being renovated this season, so they have no home games at all for their basketball season, as Hewlett is too strong there. So a team that has learned how to play on the road in a league in which it is difficult to play on the road, as that'll be a traveling violation on Trent. Gym renovations taking place for the Hawks. Hasn't stopped them from posting a 10-6 record, though, which is tough to do when night in and night out you're having to go on the road while maintaining schoolwork and all the other pressures that are on you. Mighty fine job by these young men at the College of Southern Maryland. Nice drive there, try to lay it off, ball poked away. Chris Cooley with the drive there, try to find the cutting Justin Miner. Trent able to get a hand on that one and poke it away. 13 on the shot clock. We're tied up 11 apiece. Just under 12 to go. That ball looked like it went off the Hawk leg, and it did. Nice play there by number 14, Trent. And that will be our first timeout of the evening. So timeout on the floor, timeout for the Raptors. Tied up at 11 here, under 12 to go. Caleb Scarborough on the call with you. We will be right back. Underway here. Raptors with the ball. Rowe with it. Raptors have been able to keep number five, Rasheed Cooley, in check so far. Again, I say so far because he is the leading scorer in conference at over 20 a game. Tachua with a fadeaway, not able to get it. Big rebound from the 6 foot Washington. He pushes up to Chris Cooley. He drives, takes a huge bump. He'll go to the line for two shots. That foul is going to be on number three, Marcus Trent, his first foul. Team second. Number zero, Chris Cooley at the line for the Hawks. Cooley, the freshman, averaging 5 points a game, shooting 57% from the line. And this is the first. Makes one of two. Hawks still sitting in this full court trap situation. Rowe has it now. Wiedmar just checked in for the Raptors. Setting a high screen here for Rogers. Rogers for three. Money! Great play there from the Raptors. Wiedmar setting the high screen. Rogers running off of it. That was a good looking three. The second of the night for the Raptors. Poke away there from Trent. Not able to get to it. Good defense from Trent. He has to get back. Pull up from Davis. He misses. Ball bouncing up. Big rebound again from Rowe. We've seen two great rebounds from Rowe tonight. Battling to get it. Definitely not the tallest guy out there. As Trent drives, was he in the restricted area? Blocking will be the call. Trying to see where his feet were at. Looks like the back of his foot may have been on that restricted area. That foul is on number 35, Justin Miner. His second foul. Team six, that's going to send Marcus Trent to the line for two. Trent misses the first. Marcus Trent, the sophomore, averaging just over 3 points a game, but has shot the ball incredibly well from the free throw line at 77%. Not used to seeing him miss many free throws. Makes the second. Here's Cooley with it now. Rowe all over him. Drive from Cooley. That foul's going to be on the floor. Foul's on number four, Jaden Rowe, his first foul. Team's third. Foul's on the floor. Cooley, you can see right there how quick he is with the ball. Nice feed inside. Not able to finish there was Wills. Rowe looking to push. Hawks in the man-to-man. Here's Wiedemar with it, back to the basket. Still with it, tosses it off. Here's Williams for three, short. Ball bounces out of play, that will be Hawks' ball. Raptors have been an extremely good team at home this season, winning 70% of their home games so far. A team that loves playing at home and has played extremely well. Looks like we're gonna have a foul here on number 42, Wiedemar, as he had a hold of number 20, Wills. Wiedemar's first foul, team's fourth. It's gonna bring back in Chichua. Also coming in will be number 21, Spin. Spin had to come out. His undershirt is the same color as the Hawks. The referee's making sure he changes that. The traveling calls called on Washington. Washington has definitely been kind of the catalyst for this Hawks team early on. Has the ball in his hand a lot and is looking to attack the basket quite often. Going to be interesting to see when number five, Rasheed Cooley, tries to take over this game. Hawks still in that man-to-man. Rowe leading the offense here. Finds Rogers. Rogers swings it over. Chichua in. Feeds it back out to Rowe. Rowe to Rogers. Almost a steal there from Washington. He has to get back. Here's Rowe. Nice cut. Too strong. Ball bouncing around. Who has it? Looks like number 20 Wills does. Quickly ahead and nice finish from Cooley. Wow, Cooley with two draped all over him. I have no idea how he got that ball between two of those arms. Raptors leading. Here's Spin with it. Back up top to Rogers. Rogers from three, off. Foul on the floor. Looks like it's gonna be on the Hawks. That's gonna send Spin to the line. Foul is on number one, Melvin Davis. His first foul, team seventh. That is going to send number 21 Spin to the line. This will be a one-and-one opportunity. Spin averaging 3 points a game. The freshman, plays high school locally at Bethesda Chevy Chase. Makes the first. Good looking free throw there from Spin. Raptors, as I said, 10-7 on the season. They're sitting in seventh currently in conference. Hawks ninth in conference, 4-4. Both teams trying to make a push halfway into the season. Still some opportunities to make up some ground on the leaders, Howard at 6-1. Foul called here. Foul's on number zero, Christian Martin. That's gonna be his first foul, team's fifth. Big finish there by number one, Davis. Hawks have made some tough layups tonight to keep them close. Here's Rogers, Spin sets the screen. Here's Chichua for three, way too strong. Chichua, it's not his strong suit. It's not shot the ball well from deep this season. Drive there from Davis, he goes up, misses it. Spin affected that shot and he rebounded it. Here's Rogers up to Chichua, terrible idea there. Rogers trying to find Chichua. What a finish, holy cow. Melvin Davis going up and taking a load of contact, able to get that one to fall. fouls on number one, Marcus Rogers, his first foul, team six. That's going to send Davis to the line. Davis absolutely exploded off the court there. Took a load of contact, was able to finish that one. Davis averages 14 points a game with a three-point opportunity completed. Rowe on the far side, he looks to drive, Chichua up top, hands it off to Martin. Raptors look a little lost right now offensively, trying to figure out what to do. Five on the shot clock, Martin gets bumped. Air ball, no call there. It looks like Martin got bumped on the shooting arm. No call there from the refs. That will be an air ball for the Raptors. Raptors trail by two, seven to go here in this first half. Caleb Scarborough with you. Thanks for tuning in to this Montgomery College Raptors broadcast on the Montgomery College YouTube channel. Here's Davis for three, made it. Davis with six quick points here in the last 45 seconds. As Rowe almost turns it over, ball bounces around, Hawks have it. Here's Davis again, he goes up, he's bumped, no call. Ball bounces around, it's gonna stay with the Hawks. Wow, we are back and forth here. The Hawks trying to get a little bit of separation, up by five now. Melvin Davis on a personal 6-0 run here. Here's Cooley, he goes up. No call. Cooley playing defense all over Martin. And we will have a foul. Foul is on number five, Rasheed Cooley. That's his first foul, team's eighth. Almost a little bit of a frustration foul there from Cooley. It definitely looked like he got fouled on his offensive possession. Kind of got him fired up. Was still under control, but sometimes when you miss that call, your defense kind of gets ratcheted up, and one of those things that shouldn't have made that foul, one of those ticky-tacky type fouls that I'm sure Coach Hoyt won't be pumped about. Nevertheless, though, Raptors missed the front end of the 1-1. Here's Hewlett, he drives, Chichua over him, sky hook pass, way too hard, an absolute missile there from Hewlett. Not sure if he's frustrated at Wills for missing it or at himself for throwing it 95 miles an hour. Here's Rowe, Cooley draped all over him. Williams sets the screen, that's gonna be an illegal screen. Fouls on number 24, Terrence Williams, his first, that'll be the team's seventh. Only a matter of time for that one called. That's one of those that your feet aren't set, if your body is still moving, it's just an easy call there for the refs to make. Raptors double team, great job there from Williams. Getting a hand on that one. Possession arrow points towards the Raptors, be Raptors ball. Great job there from Williams. Hedging really hard on that ball screen to be able to get out and double team. Feeds it into Chichua. Spin move, still working, goes up, tough shot, not able to get it to fall. Wills with the rebound, pushes it, and that will be a shooting foul. It's gonna send number zero Cooley to the line for two shots. That foul is on number four, Jaden Rowe, his second foul. Team's eighth, sending Cooley to the line for two shots. Chris Cooley, the little brother of number five, Rasheed Cooley. Rasheed the sophomore, Chris the freshman. And we have a timeout, quick timeout, 30-second timeout by the Hawks. That'll give us a second to step away. We'll be right back. Raptors trailing 17-23. Underway here in Rockville, Maryland. Caleb Scarborough on the call here. Maryland Junior College matchup between these two conference foes. Both of them right in the middle of the pack, sitting in seventh place and ninth place midway through our junior college basketball season. Tachua has it. He's posting up, feeds it inside to a cutting Trent. Beautiful play there. Excellent off-ball movement from Trent, and that's an easy two-point basket. Can the Raptors get a stop? Cooley with a step back. He's way off. Rebounded from Wills. He gets the long rebound. Swings it over. We know Washington will shoot. He's off, and the Raptors rebound it. Nice rebound there from Trent. Neither team shooting the ball well from deep tonight or during the season. As Hewlett gets the steal and then chucks that one into the Raptors. Ball go right back to the Raptors. Trent hands it off to his brother Trent. Back to Trent. Here's Williams for three. He's short. Ball rebounded. Looking to push hard the Hawks. And they will get a foul. Hawks looking to rebound and get out on the run. As that foul's on number 24, Terrence Williams, his second foul, team's ninth. We've seen the Hawks do that a handful of times here in the first half, getting that rebound. They've got one man just absolutely flying down the court, trying to find him for an easy breakaway layup. Those fast break points are at a premium. A team like the Hawks who score almost 88 points a game, they know how to get out on transition. Tough shot there, Chachua. Ooh, man, that was close. Great play there from Trent. Looks like he may have snatched the arm of the Hawk. That was real close there by Trent to have that breakaway layup. Nevertheless, that will send Washington to the line for two shots. Washington averages 10 points a game. The freshman played his high school ball at Rock Creek Christian High School. Makes the first. Good crowd here tonight at Montgomery College. Classes are back underway here for the spring semester, so lots of student athletes have made their way back to campus as spring seasons are really close to getting started here for a lot of teams. Nice feed inside from Chachua. And Trent's going to be fouled. Great feed from Chachua inside. That'll send Trent to the line for two shots. Foul's on number three, Reggie Washington. His second foul, team's ninth. It's going to send Trent to the line here for two shots. Trent, second leading scorer for the Raptors at almost 12 points a game. makes the first. Trent the lefty. It's going to bring back in number zero, Chris Cooley, for the Hawks. And he makes the second. Nice shooting there from Trent. He's played well here in this first half. Cooley with the Euro step. He's way off, able to get up off the ground to get his own rebound. Spins and hits the mid-range shot. Excellent job there from Cooley to rebound from that bad shot and find himself an easy mid-range pull-up. Chichua with the spin, turns it over. Hawks looking to push, here's Washington. He has a man, Cooley. Chichua gets back though, excellent work by Chichua. The man has a motor. He will get up and down the floor. He is a hustle player. As I said, not always the tallest guy whenever he plays, but just an incredible motor and drive to get the ball. Ball bounced around. Looks like it went off a Hawk. Raptors ball. That's going to bring in number 11, Tyler Farkas. Farkas, the freshman out of Charles E. Smith High School. Farkas has seen a lot of action this season, his 16th game of the season. Here's Chichua, he sets the screen. Back to Chichua, what a play. Excellent two-man game there from Marcus Trent and William Chichua. Easy dunk for Chichua as Cooley drives in. Looked like he was blocked by Farkas, but Miner able to snatch that one to lay it up for two. Great help defense there by Farkas, just came off the bench. Here's Chichua, he's gonna turn that one over. Here's Washington, he drives, left hand, takes a lot of contact, no call. Great play by Martin to keep it alive. Here's Chichua, back over to Trent. Trent goes up, he takes a lot of contact, wild shot. Cooley rebounds, he pushes it to Washington. Washington drives, ball poked away, foul. Wow, back and forth here the last 30 seconds. Foul will be on zero. Christian Martin is second foul. Team's 10th. It's gonna send number three, Reggie Washington, to the line for two shots. Under two to play here, Raptors trailing by four. Washington makes the first. And makes the second. Hawks on this five-game winning streak, trying to extend it to six. Raptors trying to bounce back from a blowout loss on Wednesday night. Difficult shot there by Trent. He had number 21 with Hewlett all over him. Here's Washington, he turns that one over. The thing we've seen about Washington here in this first half, incredible speed, attacks the basket hard, gets into the lane, but some of those last second decisions have been lacking a little bit. Both teams prone to turnovers. Chichua, he kicks it out. Here's Marquise Trent for three. Good! Marquise Trent from deep. Third three of this first half for the Raptors. Less than a minute to go. Cooley kicks it back out. Here's Washington. He'll take a three. In and out. Marquise Trent rebounds. He kicks it over. Here's Rogers. He goes up and finishes. Raptors down by one. Raptors with a quick 5-0 run. About 10 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Here's Cooley in the corner. He's off. Ball bounces around. Looks like we have a foul. Foul is on zero, Chris Cooley. That'll be his first foul. It'll be team's 10th. The foul was a flopping call. So trying to figure out here, it will be a technical shot for the Raptors. So Raptors will take one shot, so it'll be Rogers at the line for one. A new rule that they've put into effect is for flopping calls that does create a technical foul. So that shot is taken by any Raptor that the team chooses. So Rogers will go to the line for one shot. Not sure who the ball was rebounded by. We'll have to see what is decided here. Looks like it will be Hawks' ball. All right. So Rogers misses the technical on the flop. It'll be Hawks' ball inbounding here. 22 seconds on the game clock. Should be 20 on the shot clock. Yeah, that is correct. So 2 seconds going to separate our game clock and shot clock here. Raptors down by one. As Rasheed Cooley inbounds it to his brother, Chris. Washington set up the offense. He kicks it over near side to Hewlett. 10 on the shot clock. Hewlett looks for some space. Farkas all over him. Hewlett drives. He kicks it down. Here's Wills back out to Washington. Short. Lots of whistles being blown there. I think the Raptors are going to get the ball with 2 seconds. So, inadvertent whistle there. What happened? There was 2 second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Ball was shot, rebounded by the Raptors. Inadvertent whistle was blown, so there will be 1 second left here in our first half. Raptors with a chance to catch it and throw this one up and to take the lead into half. We'll see what they run. Here's Rogers. Too much time there. That one is not going to count. And so our score at the halftime buzzer, Raptors trailing by one. Raptors 30, College of Southern Maryland Hawks 1. We'll be right back here for the second half. Thanks for tuning in to this Montgomery College YouTube broadcast. My name's Caleb Scarborough. We'll be right back at Montgomery College for our second half matchup between these two foes in the Maryland Junior College Conference.
Come on, y'all. They work very hard. Very hard.
Thank you.
that? We're starting. Obviously during the break. Yeah, I'm pretty confident. What's the first beat? Unless the whole team.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the beautiful campus of Montgomery College. We are in Rockville, Maryland. Caleb Scarborough here with you on the call. Raptors trailing by one here in this Maryland Junior College matchup between two teams right in the middle of the conference standings. Raptors 10-7 overall, 5-4 in conference. They dropped their last game on Wednesday night, losing by 29 in that one. On the flip side for the Hawks, 10-6 overall, they are 4-4 in conference. They have won 5 in a row, an impressive feat considering the Hawks have not played a single game at home this season. Their gym is ongoing construction at their gym, so they cannot play any home games this season as Cooley tries to get hot here in the second half. Rasheed Cooley, the leading scorer in conference, gets himself started here in the second half. Like I said, this Hawks team, a team that's played incredibly well when you consider the fact they haven't played any home games, so traveling during the middle of the week and the weekends and taking classes on top of it, that is a lot for these young men as Chichua gets the rebound and misses the layup. Step back here. Pulls it back, swings it over to Washington. Washington kicks it over to Cooley. Screen set by Wills. Cooley fades away, tough shot. Ball bounces around. Rowe finds himself on the end of it. He has it. Looks to shake and bake, not able to do so. Here's Marquise Trent for three. Good! Trent from deep. Second three of this evening for Trent. 4-3 overall for the Raptors. Again, a team that only makes about 5 a game. Defense! Nice move there by Wills. Twisting and turning and getting that easy layup. Wills, fourth leading scorer. The Hawks have four guys in double figures. Excuse me, five guys. All five of their starters in double figures. An incredible feat as Davis gets an easy layup. A team that averages 87 points a game right now, well under their season average. The Raptors average 77 points a game. Martin kicks it back out to Chichua. Here's Trent for three again. Off the back of the rim. Rowe gets the deep rebound. Martin for three. Off the back of the rim again. And that is going to be a foul on Williams. Foul on number 24, Williams. That is his third foul. Team's first. Williams is going to have to take a seat here for Coach Wise's team as he is in early foul trouble here in the second half. Washington drives. Ball pokes away. Nice play there from Chichua, ripping that one away for a steal. Here's Trent back inside. Easy layup by Rogers. Great hockey assist there from Chichua. Swinging it over to Trent. Trent bounce passing it over to Rogers. On the other end, we're going to have a foul. Shooting foul. Fouls on zero. Christian Martin, his third foul. Team second. It's going to send Rasheed Cooley to the line for two shots. As I said, Cooley, leading scorer in conference at 22 points a game. Cooley shooting 73% from the free throw line. Some incredible stats from Cooley. Shooting 44% from the field, 40% from deep, and then 73% from the free throw line. Had just a fantastic season for Coach Alan Hoyt's club. Raptors down by four, 17 to go. Couple of Raptors here in foul trouble. Marquise swings it to Marcus. Here's a three from the corner. That one's off, rebounded by Rasheed Cooley, who kicks it out. Here's Hewlett, and he will be fouled. Fouls on number one, Marcus Rogers, his second foul. Team's third is going to send number 21, Hewlett, to the line. Hewlett's averaging 14 points, a freshman out of North Point High School. Hewlett's shooting 73% from the free throw line. Misses the first. Raptors are missing one of their key rotation players tonight. Number 32, Philip Carter, was not in uniform. As I said, a key rotation player for Coach Wise's team. Not sure if it's an injury or what, but was not in uniform tonight. Here's Rowe. He gets by Washington. Spins back out. Here's Chichua. Over to Marcus. Marcus drives. Layup with a finish there. Marcus Trent using that offhand to get a little bit of space. Able to lay that one off the backboard for a beautiful looking layup as Hewlett is going to be fouled on the floor. Foul is on number one, Marcus Rogers. That'll be his third foul. Team's fourth. Raptors racking up some early fouls here in the second half. That's three players with three fouls. Drive here from Hewlett with the hook shot. He airballs it. Chichua skies for it. Here's Marcus Trent. He throws that one right to the Raptors bench. Try to find Rogers in the corner, but Rogers is cutting to the basket. Marcus trying to guard Cooley. Cooley gets a switch. Shachua with a tough matchup here. Trying to feed it inside, and that's going to be a foul on Marcus Trent. His second foul. Team's fifth. Raptors racking up five team fouls here in a little over 4 minutes of action in this second half. Washington was active in that first half for the Hawks, as it looks like we're going to have a foul on number 20, Wills, his first foul, team's first. Looked like he may have hooked Chachua coming around that screen. Got his arm wrapped around Chachua. Push off there from Rowe, no call. Here's a three, that one's off. Rogers rebounds it. Kicks it inside, Chachua wide open under the basket, and he finds him. The whole Raptors bench screaming at Trent to find Chachua with the ball. Finally did, and Chachua using that 6'7" frame to rise up and bury that one. Raptors looking to push. Here's Rogers. He drives, lays it off. That ball poked away by Washington. It'll stay down here with the Raptors. Chachua going up, spins, able to finish. Not a great pass there from Marcus Trent, but Chachua able to get a hold of it, do a beautiful spin move and lay that one up. Chachua active here in this second half. Here's a screen. Wills inside. He drives. Looks like we're going to have a foul call. Fouls on number one, Marcus Rogers, his fourth foul. Tough call there. That one looked like it could have gone either way. Could have been a travel. Could have been a foul. It was one of those 50-50 calls. Either way, Rogers will have to take a seat with four fouls. Nice drive from Davis. He underhands that one. Beautiful finish. Rowe setting up the offense. Dribble handoff to Marcus. Spin sets the ball screen. Hand off to Marquise, back to Marcus. Inside to Chachua. Here's Marquise, he's hit two tonight from deep. Over to Chachua, eight on the shot clock, back to Rowe. He's got Cooley draped all over him, tosses it out. And that will be a Raptors turnover here. Raptors only down by one. They've been able to contain number five, Cooley, thus far. We know he can get hot in a hurry, though. Here's Cooley. He's got Marquise all over him. Cooley drives, pulls up from mid-range. That one bounces in and out. Chachua with the rebound. Marcus looking to push. He's got numbers. And rebounded and foul. Spin will go to the line. Foul is on number three, Reggie Washington, his third foul. Team second. It's gonna send spin to the line for two shots. Raptors with an opportunity to take the lead. In and out on the first. Yeah. Makes one of two. Quick timeout here from Coach Wise. That'll give us an opportunity to remind you. You keep up with all things Raptors at mcraptors.com. You can also keep track of all of Raptors athletics on the Montgomery College Raptors YouTube channel. Give you a quick update on some other updates across the conference and here at Montgomery College. Raptors will be back in action here, away on Friday, February the 3rd. They'll be taking on Hartford Community College. Hartford, a game ahead of the Raptors right now, so a big matchup for your Raptors next week. Give you a couple updates on the standings so far. Howard in first place in the conference, 6-1 in conference, 15-4 overall. Allegheny at 4-1, 15-7 overall. Prince George's at 7-2, 16-3 overall. So Prince George's, they've played 9 games so far. Howard has only played 7, and Allegheny has only played 5. So there's going to be a lot of movement over the next couple weeks in this conference. Lots of games in February. The Raptors will play their final game on February the 24th, and so the Raptors have about 7 more conference matchups between now and then, and so a lot of movement going to take place in those conference standings. You can keep track of all of that on the mdjuco.org website. Back in our way here, Raptors tied up here with the Hawks. Hawks on a 5-game winning streak as Darius Fletcher gets himself on the scoreboard. We saw Fletcher in that first half. He played about 4 minutes and picked up 2 quick fouls. Washington with good hands. He pokes that one away. Tough pass to handle there from Hewlett. He fires that one in. Miner was not able to control that one. Ball goes out of play. It'll be Raptors ball. Chichua's going to get a quick break. Viedmar checks back in. Viedmar, he gets slapped there. That foul will be on number 35, Justin Miner. His third foul, team's third. Viedmar with it. He's backing him down. Has to pull it back out. Here's Marcus. 10 on the shot clock. Viedmar with the ball screen. Laid off to Viedmar. Viedmar drives and finishes. Foul is on number 4, Darius Fletcher. His third foul, team's fourth. Tough finish there from Viedmar. That ball was a hot potato there for a second. It bounced around. I'm not even sure how he got enough on it to be able to lay it up, but great strength from the sophomore as he completes the 3-point play. Raptors with a little bit of full court pressure. Hawks able to escape it. Here's Cooley from deep. Money! Rasheed Cooley, my goodness. Second three of the night for the Hawks. Cooley hit that one about 4 feet behind the 3-point line. Marcus with a tough fadeaway, he misses. Viedmar battles, he rips it away. Ball will stay down here. Raptors ball, great effort there from Viedmar, snatching that one away. Here's Viedmar, he drives, goes in strong. Viedmar misses, gets his own rebound, goes up, makes it. What a play there from Wiedmar. Excellent hustle from Wiedmar. 5 quick points for him off the bench. As Rowe gets the steal, looking to push over to Marquise. Marquise with the layup, it is good. Raptors on a 7-0 run. 2-point lead, Raptors. 11 minutes to go here in this second half. Lots of energy in this building now. Wiedmar gonna be called with the foul here. That'll be his second, team 7th. That is going to send Washington to the line for a 1-1. Hawks in the bonus for the next 10 minutes and 53 seconds. So a lot of time left on this clock. Going to be a lot of free throw opportunities for the Hawks, who only shoot 69% from the line. Fouls are starting to rack up for both teams. Martin and Williams with 3, Rogers with 4 for the Raptors, and then for the Hawks, Washington and Miner both with 3. And Fletcher, 3 with 3 fouls. Washington all over Rowe. He finds Marcus, lays it to Wiedmar. Wiedmar's blocked. Great block there from Fletcher. We'll see who the foul is on. Fouls on number 20. Wills, his second foul, team's 5th. That foul was called on the shot, so I'll send Chichua to the line for 2 shots. Chichua makes the first. Raptors leading by 2, 10.5 to go. Hewlett drives, hands all over him. That foul is going to be on number 42, Wiedmar, his 3rd foul. Team's 8th. That is going to send Hewlett to the line. 1-1 opportunity. Wiedmar tasked with a difficult proposition. Wow, what a block there from Chichua, but the foul will be called. Foul is on number 22, Chichua. That'll be his 2nd foul, team's 9th. It was a shooting foul. It's going to send number 21, Hewlett to the line for 2 shots. As I was saying, it's a really tough task for Wiedmar. Wiedmar with at least 3 inches on the next closest guy, probably 4. So he's being asked to guard guys that are smaller than him, and for the most part, a lot quicker. And that's a tough thing to do for a big man, to move your feet on screens, to be able to get around, to be able to move. And so right there was a perfect example of that foul that happened on him as Hewlett makes them both. Hewlett gonna take a seat. He took a hard fall on that foul. Looked like he landed on his back a little awkwardly. He's gonna come out. They're gonna take a look at him. We hope he's all right. See how he's doing. Hate to see a young man come out of the game with an injury. Here's Wiedmar, he's driving. Tough take from Wiedmar, he's too strong. Ball bouncing around, who's it off of? Last touch by Trent. Ball goes the other way. 10:01 to go here at Montgomery College. K Caleb Scarborough on the call. Thanks for tuning in to this Montgomery College broadcast on the Montgomery College Athletics YouTube channel. Tough take there from Washington. He's not able to finish. Wiedemark touches it to Rowe. Rowe's looking to push. Finds Marquise in the corner. He thinks about it. Kicks it back in. Marcus able to avoid the defense. Here's Rowe from deep. Ball rims out. Cleared by Wills. Here's Davis. He kicks it back out to Washington. Ball screen set. Rowe gets around it. Here's the younger Cooley. Six on the shot clock. Davis thought about it. He has to chuck it up. Hits the front of the rim. Nobody rebounds, but Chachua. What a block. Wow. What a block there by William Chachua. Foul real quick will be on Reggie Washington. That'll be his fourth foul. Team sixth. Chachua rose up and absolutely swallowed that ball. Saved his team there because Davis for the Hawks had to just chuck up a prayer of a three with the shot clock winding down. The ball kissed the very front of the rim and no Raptor went to the ball. Fletcher rebounded it, had a clear run to the basket, and William Chachua with that absolute motor comes over and rises up. Wiedemar not able to grab that one. And Cooley's off to the races. Easy 2 points. And we have a timeout for the Raptors. That'll give us a chance to step away. Raptors trailing by two. 8:36 to go here in our second half. Underway here at Montgomery College. Raptors trailing by two. Martin back in the game for the Raptors. He has three fouls. Feeds it to Wiedemar. Wiedemar at the top. Hands it off to Rogers. Rogers pulls up for three. Off. Wiedemar able to get the rebound though. It looks like he will be fouled. Wait. We're going the other direction. Discussion between the refs. What's the call? Wow. Foul on number 42, Wiedemar. His fourth foul, team's 10th. Wow. That's a tough call. That is a really tough call there to make. Wiedemar just really bigger than stronger than Cooley. Cooley's only listed at 6'1", if that. Wiedemar has at least 8 inches on him, and that's a tough call to make that one on Wiedemar as Cooley makes the first. Wiedemar's got 4, Rogers has got 4, Williams has got 3, and Martin has 3. So the Raptors with a lot of foul trouble. Hawks have turned up the pressure here. Nice drive there from Martin. Excellent work. Finishing with the right hand. Here's Cooley, shake and bake, drives by Williams, kicks it down to Fletcher. And we have an offensive foul charge on number 5, Rasheed Cooley, his second foul. That'll be the team's 7th. Cooley's got to be careful here, and that's exactly what happened in the first half. Quick foul there on Cooley. 2 quick fouls on him. That puts him at 3. Same thing happened in that first half. Cooley drove, didn't get the foul call, was not happy with it, turned up his energy defensively, and got called for the same sort of ticky-tack foul at midcourt. And so something that the young man just definitely allowed the referees to kind of get in his head and dictate his actions out there. He'll have to regroup. The Hawks will need him to, as he is such an integral part, scoring almost a quarter of their points each matchup. So Martin's at the line for a 1-1. Hawks have 18 fouls. Both teams will be in the bonus from here on out, as Chichua shows why he's the second leader rebounder in conference. As Rogers from 3 misses it, Chichua rises up and gets the rebound. What a play there from William Chichua. Chichua averaging almost 10 rebounds a game, and that right there, ladies and gentlemen, is that motor I have talked about all night long. Here's the younger Cooley, pulls up from mid-range, he's off, row rebounds, pushes it, here's Chichua, he'll throw it down! William Chichua throwing it down, Raptors up by 3. Foul call, what is it? Foul on number 4. Jaden Rowe is 3rd foul. Team is in the double bonus. Rowe, man, took an absolute collision there. Man, he went knee to knee there. It's a horrible feeling. We're trying to see what the call is going to be. Jaden Rowe is up walking. That is a great sign because the dude took an absolute hit on the knee. And if you've ever hit knee to knee with somebody, it is a horrible feeling. Jaden Rowe showing some toughness right now, up and moving. The freshman out of Thomas Wooten High School. That's going to send Wills to the line for 2 shots. Raptors leading, under 7 to go here in this Maryland Junior College matchup between 2 teams trying to climb the standings. Both of them in the middle of the pack right now. A little less than a month left in the season as Jaden Rowe goes up for the layup. Goaltending is the call. We will count that basket. Jaden Rowe looks all right, ladies and gentlemen. That was an explosive move to get to the rim. Excellent play from the freshman. Here's Cooley, feeds it inside. Wills has it poked away. Hewlett able to find it. He goes up, he misses. Ball bounces around. Williams rebounds. Williams finds Rowe. Rowe over to Rogers, who drives. Floater, good. Rowe with the assist to Rogers. Rogers with the floater, excellent play. Largest lead of the night for the Raptors. Up by five. Tachua able to grab that one as Hewlett is down. What is the call? Charge. That is on zero. Christian Martin, his fourth foul. Hewlett, looks like it may be some cramps. Either way, his teammates are going to help him up, and we will take a break. Time out on the floor. Raptors up by five. 5:27 to go in this matchup. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Rockville, Maryland. Caleb Scarborough on the call here with you. Both teams in the double bonus as we continue the final 5:20 in this matchup between the 7th place and 9th place teams in the Maryland Junior College standings as Cooley makes it rain from deep. Cooley has been held beneath his season average. But on the flip side, what a basket by number one, Marcus Rogers. That foul was on number four, Darius Fletcher, his fourth foul, team's ninth. Rogers, what a finish there by the young man. He'll get a chance for a three-point play. It's exactly how you answer a big bucket from the Hawks. The Raptors just gave up that deep three from Cooley. Went down the other end and got a three-point play themselves as Cooley goes to the rim and gets fouled. Holy cow, ladies and gentlemen, we are back and forth. Foul is on number 24, Terrence William, his fourth foul. Team is in the double bonus. That's going to send Cooley to the line. I'm not sure what Coach Hoyt told Rasheed Cooley during that timeout. But Cooley with 6 quick points in the last 20 seconds, a guy that knows how to score, and the Raptors have kept him in check up until this point, and you cannot let him get going, and I'm afraid he has. Here's Rogers for deep. Good! Marcus Rogers. Rogers and Cooley dueling here in this last minute. Back and forth they go. Cooley thought about it. I thought we were about to see a heat check moment. As Washington drives, he has a lot of contact. What's the call? Foul. It'll be a shooting foul. Foul is on zero, Christian Martin. That is his fifth foul. Team is in the double bonus. Stuff to sort through there. So Christian Martin picked up his fifth foul. When that happens, the free throw can't take place. Okay, so when the fifth foul is called, that student athlete has to be subbed out at that moment. And so the problem is the free throw was taken and then the substitution occurred, which is against the rules of the game. So the substitution should have happened. There is a little bit of a time, 10, 15 seconds that takes place. And so just one of those things that, in the grand scheme of things, it's not a big deal. But if you're a lover of the game and you like to follow the rules of the game, that is something that needs to be followed. Let's keep an eye on that because there is a lot of foul trouble. As Rogers pulls up, he misses. But this is going to go the other way. That's going to be on Williams. If it is, that's his fifth. And it is. That's Williams' fifth foul. So that's Williams' fifth foul. So he has fouled out as well. That is going to send number 21, Hewlett, to the line. Going to bring in number 21, Spin. So normally what needs to take place when the fifth foul happens, okay? Couple things. One, the horn should go off, right? The horn signifies a substitution needs to take place or there's something at the scorer's table that needs to be addressed. If that horn doesn't go off, you can't expect the referees to keep track of who has how many fouls, right? Like, I have a piece of paper and I'm watching the game and it's hard for me to keep track of the fouls. And so the refs aren't expected to know that. That is a scorer table thing where the horn needs to be blown or the scorekeeper needs to raise his hand up and hold up five, something like that. But that's kind of where and the reason we have these kind of lulls in our stoppage here with some of these fouls. Five on the shot clock. Chichua goes up and dunks it. Holy cow. William Chichua chucks that one through the net. That foul's on number 20, Wills, his third foul. Team is in the double bonus. Chichua to the line to try and complete the three-point play. Lane violation there from Chichua. He knew he missed it and took off to try to get his own rebound. Can't really blame him. A guy that loves to hunt for the ball off the glass. So I saw that he was going to miss it and just said, I'm going to go get this ball. But fortunately, in the college game, can't be doing that. So that will be a turnover. Foul going the other way here. That's going to be an over the back on number 20, Wills. His fourth foul. That is going to send Chichua to the line for two shots. A lot of foul trouble here now. Hawks got three players with four fouls. So Washington, Fletcher, and Wills all with four fouls. For the Raptors, Rogers with four fouls, Viedmar with four fouls, Rowe with three, and they're already down two starters. Martin and Williams have both fouled out. Raptors push their lead to 6 points. Go, go, go. Here's Cooley with it now. What's he going to do? We know he'll attack. Here he goes. He's tied up. What's the call? Foul. Going to say Cooley to the line. That foul is on number one, Marcus Rogers. That is his fifth foul. Wow. Tough. So that will send Cooley to the line. It is two shots. They are in the double bonus. Correction, that is Rogers' fourth foul. They looks like we've changed the foul from earlier and taken it off of Rogers, so he only has four. So my bad on that one, four fouls for Rogers. There is a timeout on the floor. Raptors leading by four, 3:19 to go. We'll be right back for the conclusion of this Maryland Junior College matchup. Raptors up by four, 3:19 to go here at Montgomery College. Here's Rogers from deep. He's off. Rebounded there by Cooley, who looks to push. Here's Davis. He goes up. No foul called. Ball pauses on the rim and bounces to spin. Great defense there from Rogers without fouling. Here's Rogers, he drives, kicks it over to Trent. Trent with the floater, that one's too strong. He gets his own rebound. Chichua finds it, spins and lays it up. Good play there. Here's Cooley, he drives past Chichua, goes up, reverse, he's blocked. Here's Wills over his head. What a finish there from Wills. What an athletic play by the freshman. Finishing that one over his head, really. Trent drives, goes for the reverse. Ball bounces around. Chichua not able to get a hold of it. Hawks look to drive. Here's Hewlett. He Euro steps through, flips it up, and he will be fouled. Hewlett to the line for two. Foul is on number 21. Spin. His first foul. Team is in the double bonus. So Spin has two fouls. That's whenever I told you earlier, Rogers only had four. Took a foul away from him, applies to Spin there in that first half. So Spin with two fouls, Rogers with four, Rowe with three, Viedmar with four. Timeout on the floor, timeout Hawks. Lead has been cut down to two. We are under 2 minutes to go here at Montgomery College. Caleb Scarborough on the call. We will be right back after this. Welcome back, Raptors, up by two. Refs are getting ready to drop the ball here as the Raptors taking a long time to break the huddle from their timeout. The refs were a little lenient there. I've seen them at times just throw the ball down and start counting. Rowe with it. He has Washington all over him. Washington flops a bit. Now Washington's on the floor. Marcus Trent has it, 15 on the shot clock. Here's Rowe. Washington all over him. Rowe has it poked away, and he commits a foul. Foul is on number four. Jaden Rowe, his fourth foul. Hewlett looked like he stepped on Rowe's ankle maybe and twisted it. He's going to stay in the game, but man, he looked like he was in an awful lot of pain there. He's going to go to the free throw line. Still acting a little odd. Now he's trying to tie his shoe and looks like he's struggling to get that done. But either way, he is at the line for two shots, a chance to tie it up. He buries the first. Decides to just not even tie it and just tucks the shoelace into the side of his shoe. Now he's deciding that he's going to tie it, so... What a sequence there as Hewlett sprained his ankle, it looked like. A terrible pain. Was able to collect himself, go to the free throw line. Couldn't get his shoe tied. Made the first free throw, then decided to tie his shoe. And then missed the second. So either way, minute game here. Excuse me. Minute 20 to go, 1-point game. Raptors leading. Washington all over Rowe there. Timeout on the floor. Raptors will take a timeout. That'll give us a chance to remind you that your Raptors will be back in action next Friday as they take on Hartford Community College. That one will be away, but on February the 8th, a Wednesday at 8 p.m., Raptors will be at home as they take on the Howard Community College. You can catch that one live on the Montgomery College Raptors YouTube channel. You can keep track of everything Raptors at mcraptors.com. Make sure you take a look at the website. A lot of spring season's getting underway here shortly. Classes have just kicked off for the spring semester. Baseball, softball, track and field will all be getting underway with practices starting shortly and games and meets to follow. So keep an eye on the MC Raptors website where you can keep up with all of your Raptors athletic programs. Raptors up by one. It'll be their ball. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Raptors have done an excellent job defensively keeping this explosive Hawk offense well under their season average. Hawks have averaged 87 points a contest. And tonight, only a 72 as Rogers shoots it from deep. Marcus Rogers from downtown. And on the other end, Hewlett finishes for an and-one opportunity. foul is on number four, Jaden Rowe, his fifth foul. What a play. So, again, the bit of a hiccup we're having right here is the horn's not being hit whenever that fifth foul has gone into play. And so that's the reason that we're kind of out of sync right here. So that is five fouls on Jaden Rowe. So Rowe is going to go to the bench. Hewlett is at the line for one shot, as his basket did count. So a three-point play opportunity here for Hewlett. And he capitalizes. One-point game still. Minute to go. Rogers off the screen. He's double-teamed. People all over him. He escapes. Here's Spin. He finds Marquise, 10 on the shot clock. Double team, here's Marcus, he spins inside, lays it up, too strong, ball bounces, Chichua with the rebound, he's fouled. Foul is on number 21, Hewlett, his second foul. That will send Chichua to the line for two shots. Makes the first. Two-point game, 29 seconds to go. Chichua misses the second. Two-point game, 25 seconds to go. The shot clock is off. Hewlett drives on Spin, pulls back, steps through, floater, travel! Wow. Hewlett spun, stepped through, and took a step. Travel violation. That'll be a quick timeout on the floor. Timeout for the Hawks. Wow. Not sure if that was a full or a 30-second timeout, as the clock is not running. Looks like it was a full timeout. Now it's a 30-second timeout. So bear with me, ladies and gentlemen. I'm doing my best up here from the booth as I'm CNN stuff. So 30-second timeout. Raptors are leading by two. Raptors were leading by as much as six here in the second half. Has been a back and forth affair between these two teams. A great matchup. So 18 seconds on the clock. It will be Raptors ball. Shot clock is off. Here's Rogers. He takes a bump. Foul is going to be on number five, Rasheed Cooley. That is his fourth foul. It'll send Rogers to the line for two shots. So Rogers at the line. Rogers has been excellent in the second half, was in early foul trouble, but was able to find himself offensively in the second half. It has really helped carry this team alongside Chichua. makes a first three-point game. And makes a second big bucket there. Excellent pressure free throws from Rogers. He drills both. 4-point lead, Raptors, 79-75, 15 seconds on the clock. Timeout on the floor. It will be a 30-second timeout for the Raptors. Raptors trying to get back on their winning ways. Dropped one on Wednesday night. The Hawks currently with a 5-game winning streak. Great matchup between these two clubs here in Rockville, Maryland. Thanks for tuning into this Montgomery College broadcast on the Montgomery College Athletic YouTube channel. Caleb Scarborough here with you. We are 15 seconds away from a possible Raptors victory if they can hold on to this 4-point lead. Here's Cooley. He drives, pulls up from three. Contact, no call. Ball bounces around, and a foul. So that foul will be on number 21. Spin, his third foul. It's going to send Wills to the line for two shots. 6 seconds to go. Wills with a chance to make this a 2-point game. Misses the first. One more shot here for Wills. 3-point game. Timeout for the Hawks. The Raptors leading by three, 79-76. 30-second timeout. We will stay here as the Raptors try to hold on. Raptors will be back in action Wednesday. They will be out of town, but back at home next Friday. Thanks for tuning into this broadcast. We have had a back and forth affair between two teams right in the middle of the standings. The Raptors in seventh in the Maryland Junior College Association, and then ninth place for the Hawks. Raptors trying to kick off this final month of the season with a victory. Quick foul there. That's going to send Marquise Trent to the line. Foul is on. Try to see here. Foul's on number 21. Hewlett, his third foul. Marquise Trent at the line, two shots, 3-point game. Buries the first. Some clutch free throw shooting in the final moments of this game for the Raptors, a team that's only shot 67% from the free throw line. Has done an incredible job here in crunch time securing this lead. Trent misses the first. Ball bounces to Spin. He has it, and that should do it. Excuse me, Chachua. Who else? Who else but Chachua getting another rebound there to end this one as we have some action here in the middle of the court. Wow. Wow. So, what I do know is the game is over. So, we can wrap this one up. So, as chaos has unfolded here after this one, what we do know is the Raptors will get the victory. Final score, 80-76. Some clutch free throws at the end of this one for the Raptors to be able to hold on to this one. So the Raptors will move to 11-7 overall, 6-4 in conference. Hawks will drop to 10-7 overall, 4-5 in conference. The Hawks' five-game winning streak is ended. So back and forth here between these two teams. The Raptors did an excellent job defensively keeping this explosive Hawks offense from even getting close to their season average. So the Hawks averaged 87 points a game, and the Raptors held them to 76 points. Raptors, excellent job containing Rasheed Cooley, the leading scorer in conference, and it was not an easy task because he is an incredible basketball player. Nevertheless, William Tchoua played one incredible game, again, really, for this Raptors team. He has been so consistent this season. A reason why he is flirting with a double-double for an average this season is because of that motor and how hard he works. And tonight played an incredible role. Raptors get a huge win tonight. Like I said, we only have about a month left in this regular season, so both teams with a lot of games ahead. A lot of action taking place. Make sure you keep track of all things Raptors at mcraptors.com. Huge shout out to my man Josh on the scoreboard and the clock for us. My name's Caleb Scarborough. Thanks for tuning in to this Montgomery College Athletics broadcast. Till next time, Caleb Scarborough out. Raptors wins 80, Hawks 76.